Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am introducing a series that I am going to call the Dashboard Series. I'll figure out a more appropriate name once I put the video up. And the reason I did this is because I make lots of spreadsheets for my Etsy shop, and figuring out the formulas is not as difficult as it used to be for me because I have many tools at my disposal. What takes a lot of time is creating the dashboard. And the dashboard is so important because it's where you want to go to view information without struggling to figure out what you're looking at. It should be very intuitive. It should be dynamic. It should be automatic. And it should be good to look at. So I often spend a lot of time creating dashboards. And I figured, you know what, if I'm struggling with this, why not create template dashboards, meaning that like a structure that can be adapted to whatever database that I have to create a template for. So that's what brought me around to this tutorial idea. So what we're looking at right here on the screen is a template with just dashboard structures. And I'm showing you this because I'm going to be using these dashboard structures to actually create real template examples. So this is going to be a series, not just showing you how to create a generic dashboard structure, but I'm actually tying it to specific examples. And I have already created those templates. I just haven't recorded the video or the tutorial that we would use to create them. And I will show you those templates in this video. And then hopefully over the next few weeks or months, we will create all of them in this channel. So this might be a good time if you are interested in these types of video tutorials, go ahead and subscribe and turn on the notification. So when I post any of these new videos, you are notified automatically. All right, so first I'll start with showing you the 10 different examples that I have. Then I'll switch over my tabs to the actual templates that I have created. I also want to take the opportunity to say thank you to my current Patreon subscribers. Thank you for supporting me. If you want to support me, that's another way to do it. One advantage of being a paid member, of course, is that you will have access to the templates that I create in this video, so you don't have to create them from scratch yourself. All right, so that being said, let's jump into the first dashboard. In this video today, I'm not going to be showing you how to create these because I will use these structures to create real-life example dashboards in future videos, but I just want to show you what they look like so you get an idea of what's coming in the future videos. So here's the first one. As you can see, this area can be used to create date drop downs, and then here you have a structure that would be good for a table with information with two columns. Here we have an additional section for small tables. This area can be used for graphs, so maybe pie charts or small bar graphs, and here would be for tables. So depending on the type of information you're trying to display, this might work. Okay, so here is the next dashboard. So very similar, but this has way more options. So here we have a general display area. So you can display some information summary here. So maybe like big numbers that you want to pop out. And then we have two sections that can be used for pie charts. This would be good for a bar graph area and maybe some more pie charts here. We have two tables and there are drop-down boxes here that you can use to dynamically change the information that is displayed in this area. All right, so here is the next one. And up here, we have an area to display information. This could be summary data displayed here. And then we have these two sections that you can use to display a pie chart. Here can be used to display like a graph, maybe over time, something like that. This is a table that can be used to display information summary, like a list of things. And here we have more space for like longer graphs. All right, so the fourth one is very similar. Again, just the general idea is that the top area gives you sections that can be used to display big numbers. So like summary, number of tasks that need to be completed, number of projects that have been completed, things like that. Then you have these longer rectangles that would be perfect for graphs. So it could be line graphs. It could be bar charts. And then you have these square-ish sections that are perfect for pie charts. And you can display multiple ones down here. And then these sections can be used to display short pieces of information that need to be displayed in a table format. Okay, so now with five, the structure is slightly different. This would be ideal if you want to create a dashboard that just displays lots of charts and graphs. So you can see we have one big area for a big chart or maybe a big summary table. And you have multiple square areas that can be used to display multiple different charts. And then we have seven, which is somewhat similar. You do have the section here that you can use to summarize big pieces of information and section for pie charts and then large graph areas. And then for 7, we have all our squares in this area for our pie charts. And then we have our graphs here. And then if you need to add more, by the way, all you need to do is just copy this section and then paste it down here. And then you have more sections for pie charts and graphs. All right, let's see what 8 is. 8's going back to the borderless style where you can display summary information here, large graphs here, tables here, and you have sections for pie charts. And then for 9, we have our summary dashboard area here, 2 large rectangles, 1 really large one. So this would be a nice area for a 30-day graph where you can display dates for a whole month. So the 1st to the 30th or the 31st. And this would be a nice line graph. We have a left panel area that can be used to summarize data as well. And then let's see, dashboard number 10, similar to what we have before, is just borderless, very minimalistic, but also giving you the chance to display summary information here, squares for charts, rectangles for bar graphs, and then smaller ones that can be used to display summary numbers as well. All right, so that is it for these dashboards. I'm going to switch over to the actual real use case examples where I used some of these dashboards so that you can actually see what it looks like instead of trying to imagine what your data would look like in here. All right, so the first one I have here is for seed inventory management. And I recently got into gardening and I accumulated a lot of seeds and I wanted a way to organize all of my seeds. This is my real seed inventory, not just placeholder information. So I collected a lot of seeds and I wanted to know the different categories, their expiration dates, and some information about them. So instead of just organizing them into this database and letting it be, I created a dashboard and I used one of the structures that I just showed you from the example. And as you can see, I have some summary information here. I have some charts, graphs, and tables that organize the information. So it's so easy for me to just come here and look at the information I need. If I want specific information about a specific plant, I can select it from a dropdown and it displays the information here. All right, so the next one is an inventory, and this will probably work if you have a bar, a bakery, a coffee shop, and you can enter in all of your ingredients here, brand name, expiration dates, packaging, supplier, everything. And then the dashboard will display the summary of all of that information. And you could even add things like the upcoming expiration dates that you can filter. So what's going to expire this month, what's going to expire next month, and what's going to expire the next 6 months. So this would be something really useful if you have trouble manually keeping track of that type of information. All right. The next one is for vendors. So if you have a business where you need to organize all of your vendors in one place and you have them organized in a table like this, perfect. You can convert this to a dashboard. So here's what a dashboard would look like. It has a summary of the different types of vendors. Here is a category breakdown, payment status from your vendors, payment method, upcoming payments can be displayed here. And this is a section to display vendor information. So you can select a specific vendor and it displays their information, name, contact person, email address, phone number, things like that. And here's a breakdown of the vendor spending. So how much you're spending for each vendor and a percentage. All right, the next one is a client and invoice tracker. So you can dump in all of the information for your clients, the category, subcategory, title, contact information, address, and the invoice tied to a specific client. You can dump all that information in here and the invoice status. So have you sent the invoice? Has the invoice been paid? Things like that. So you can track all of that in the table. That works fine. And then the dashboard summarizes all of that information. So the number of clients you have, the invoice amount paid, amount unpaid, graph for the categories, some summary pie charts here. And this section here, which I think is so useful, is instead of having to go back to your table and search for specific client information, you can just select the client's name here and it displays a summary of their information here. And then here is an area for your invoices. So you can filter your invoices by paid, unpaid, overdue, things like that. All right, so here is a very general use case. So not as specific as the ones that I have shown you. This is a task management system. So everyone can use this. This can be used for home use, can be used for your business, it can be used for your work, things like that. All right, so you have a generic database of information. So here's where you would just dump in all of your tasks as they come up and assign due dates, priority, category. You could even assign it to a person if you are working with someone in your business or with your partner at home, and then fit that information into this dashboard. So this dashboard would display a summary, how many tasks that are due today, the tasks that you have completed today, any tasks that's overdue, summary area, upcoming due dates. It just organizes everything so clearly that you don't have to dig in to find useful information. The next one is a time tracker database. So if you are a freelancer, this is something that you're probably very familiar with. You have your different tasks that you have to do, and you need to know how much time you're spending on this task. So you can enter all that information here. Enter your task, assign them to a project or a client, and then you can assign your start time, your end time, and you could track the amount of hours spent. You could even track your rates per hour, so how much you're charging per hour. All right, you could track all of that in this table, and then you can display it in the dashboard. So a summary of the information can be displayed here. Things like how many hours you worked today, this week, this month, this year. And then here you can display more information and filter down the information by clients. So it would show you the task you worked on and how many hours you spent on that task, because you can change the start and the end date and select the specific clients. Then you have more graphs here that summarizes that information for you, a summary of your task by category, a summary of your task by projects. All right, and then the last one I have here is a lead tracker dashboard. Here you're tracking all of the information related to your leads, so your potential clients, right? So their contact information, how you contacted them, the source, the status, priority, and next action, right? So you add all that information here in a table, which is nice. And then in the dashboard, you can display all of your leads, how many have been converted, your conversion rates, and the amount of money. And then you can display things like the breakdown of categories here. You have several different pie charts that summarize things like lead source, status, priority. These two areas dynamically display more information. So for example, in this area, you can display your lead status. So new leads, in progress, lost, and won. So you can display even more information in this area instead of having to go back to the database. So that is all I have created right now. My question to you before I wrap this video up is, do you have additional use cases that you want me to create dashboards for? I really enjoyed the process of creating these dashboards because aside from the design aspect, which is wanting it to look good, I also had to think about what was the most important information that one would want displayed in their dashboard and how to display it in the most efficient and user-friendly way. I enjoyed the process of doing that. I did have to use a lot of my imagination because not all of these scenarios apply to me, except for the seed tracker and maybe like the task inventory and the client tracker. I could relate to some of those, but some of them I couldn't. So I really had to think about it. So I am asking you, if you watch this video and you want me to create something for your use case, leave a comment in the comment section below. Give me an example of your specific use case. And then what I can do is create a generic database and then create a dashboard for that database. If you already have a database and you're willing to share that with me, that would also work. What I can do is remove any information that could be sensitive or convert some of the numbers to something more generic and then use that to create a dashboard. So I'm looking for lots of real life examples so that I can create many dashboards that would apply to as many people as possible. So if you found this information helpful, please share this video with someone that you think would find it useful so they also would have a chance to leave a comment down below on the type of dashboard they want me to create related to their specific use case. And I also want to say that I have already created this spreadsheet. All I need to do is recreate the tutorial to create them. So it will be happening for sure. Don't worry about it. Just give me time and I will try to release a new one every week or so. And finally, of course, if you are a paid Patreon member, every week I release this template, you will get a notification as well as a copy of the templates. All right, so thank you so much. I am really excited to get started with this series. I had a lot of fun creating these dashboards, and I hope that I will be able to share a lot with you, and I hope you're able to get something out of it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.